Blackstone Publishing presents Whistleblowers, Honesty in America, From Washington to Trump, by Allison Stanger. This book is read by Kate Mulligan. The whole art of government consists in the art of being honest. Thomas Jefferson, 1774. Not everything that is faced can be changed, but nothing can be changed until it is faced. James Baldwin, 1962. Introduction. The Paradox. We are unknown to ourselves, we knowers, and with good reason. We have never looked at ourselves. Friedrich Nietzsche, 1887. Whistleblower rights and protection in the United States are as old as the Republic itself. In 1777, during the Revolutionary War, 10 American naval officers revealed that their commodore, Essex Hopkins, had tortured captured British sailors. They submitted a petition to the Continental Congress alleging that Hopkins had treated prisoners in the most inhumane and barbarous manner. Congress voted to remove Hopkins from his position, and Hopkins retaliated by accusing two of the whistleblowing sailors of libel and having them arrested. The imprisoned whistleblowers, Richard Marvin and Samuel Shaw, petitioned Congress to secure their release from prison. Congress ruled in their favor and, in response to the situation, issued the world's first whistleblower protection law on July 30, 1778. Its language captures the intimate relationship that the founders perceived between the upholding of whistleblower rights and the maintenance of the Republic. That is the duty of all persons in the service of the United States, as well as all other inhabitants thereof, to give the earliest information to Congress or any other proper authority of any misconduct, frauds, or misdemeanors committed by any officers or persons in the service of these states, which may come to their knowledge. Congress did not stop at upholding whistleblowing. Although the country was at war and strapped for resources, Congress paid the legal fees of Marvin and Shaw. Congress also passed a law to ensure that future whistleblowers would have legal counsel to fight libel charges. In a final demonstration of its convictions, Congress authorized that all records related to Hopkins' removal be released to the public. Thus, even before the Constitution became America's basic law, the importance of whistleblowing as a means of exposing important truths was part of the new nation's DNA. Ideals and practice, however, would too often diverge. What is whistleblowing? Whistleblowing has been present since the United States' founding, but the concept means different things to different people. To have a meaningful national conversation on whistleblowing, we have to start with a common definition, stripped of partisan leanings. That is the only way to see what has changed and what hasn't in the treatment of American whistleblowers. For starters, just thinking oneself a whistleblower isn't enough. A whistleblower cannot be defined as an advocate for the change I'd like to see. That definition confuses whistleblowing with political activism, and it invites partisan interpretations. The usually precise Oxford English Dictionary, showing an awareness of this confusion, skirts it with a circular definition. A whistleblower is one who blows the whistle on a person or activity, especially from within an organization. The Cambridge Dictionary definition is narrower. A whistleblower is a person who tells someone in authority about something they believe to be illegal that is happening, especially in a government department or a company. The Whistleblower Protection Act of 1989, which was strengthened in 2012 through the Whistleblower Protection Enhancement Act, comports with the Cambridge definition. Federal employees who disclose illegal or improper government activities are protected from supervisors' or coworkers' retaliation. According to the U.S. Merit Systems Protection Board, MSPB, whistleblowing is...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.